Okay, class, I think you should all give a nice warm welcome to the newest member of Zeos' cabinet, the own X7S, Class A balanced headphone amplifier. Now, I saw this on Mass Drop, and anyone who's been to Mass Drop knows exactly what you do when you find something you really want on Mass Drop. You see how much it is on Amazon, so you don't wait 5 months for it to arrive. And they had this for $200 or $210. It was $250 free shipping on Amazon, and I went, okay, fuck it. Because A, I don't want to wait. B, I don't want to wait. And C, I really don't want to wait. So, sure enough, it shipped from China and got to me before the Mass Drop had ended. So, I win, I guess. Now, I ordered it in black. I ordered it from the only page on Amazon, even says I ordered it from here. In black, to match my black one, my black X1S, and it arrived, and on the package was a note that said, only had it in silver. So, there's a chance if you order it from Amazon, and there's one left in stock from this seller and two others from different sellers, it's a gamble of where you're going to get it, what color it's going to be. And honestly, I'm okay with it being silver, because I have sort of a silver black thing going on anyway. And I think it looks actually pretty fucking spectacular in silver. What is it? It's a Class A, which means... I'll explain Class A. Class A means there is no switching on the amplification. Most amplifiers you get in like receivers and stuff, they only work hard when there's something to work. If I plug this in and turn it on, it's at full amplification. Right, just with nothing plugged into it. It's going. It's just any signal that comes in is gone. Is going and being amplified. And it's just full. There's no gates. There's no valves. It's much simpler, but it also gets very hot and it's not very efficient. But audiophiles and people in general who talk about speakers and headphones want Class A. Now, actually, I should look up the specs so I could actually read the specs, because I don't want to guess the specs. Good, I'm glad they're organized neatly in that paragraph. Power. Output power. Output power. Output power. Jesus Christ, this is hard to read. A watt at 300 ohms? What about less? 300 RC? This is like written in Chinese. Anything better than this? Hold on. You're gonna watch me look things up on camera. Own's website's actually pretty decent if it pops up here. Yes, it does. Boom. We'll get to look at the inside of it. Ooh, it's gonna be nice. New releases. New Own products, yes. Yes, 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 yes. There she is. Can I actually look at specs, you bitch? I like how they do the outlines of the units you could buy from them. Alright, this is just a giant image, by the way. It just loads one. I don't know what website decided that that's like just loading one massive image is how you do it. I could zoom it out. There, I'll zoom it out. Zoom out the whole image. Give me your speckamafoos. There's the inside of it. It's literally a heatsink and a bunch of capacitors, and that's it. Now, the power brick for this is exactly the same as the power brick for the X1S, and I'm not digging it out from back there because it's a brick. It's like the size of this transformer on the Dark Voice, but sitting back there, and it comes out and it's got positive and it's got double polarity, I think 12 or 15 volt. So a custom power supply that's required. Internal photos is simple. Give me specs. Okay, background, good. I can't even control F to search anything. There, specifications are a separate thing. Thank you. Nice and simple and organized. Total harmonic distortion plus noise. 0 point, and everything's got three zeros before a digit appears. So, 0.00014, 0.00013. Basically, Own sold me with this. Own sent me the X1S. They contacted me and they sent it to me. And when this arrived, I didn't even hesitate to buy it. Just buy it. I'm going to contact them. Screw that. That's my favorite headphone DAC amp still. I mean, a Hot 2 doesn't really count for a desktop. And you can get a shit stack or the Fola 2, and those are cute. But this, even though I've always claimed it as being like less powerful than most things, it handled 600 ohm headphones fine. And now I've got the add-on module, which means it'll handle everything. Because max output power, it's only claiming 1 watt per channel out of the quarter inch. And out of the balance, 1.7 watts per channel at 32 ohm. So at least it's at the correct value. Class A power, 200 milliwatts at 32 ohm. I'm assuming that at some points it'll switch out of Class A. Yeah, I don't. It can power Class A for a good deal. Now, over there, Jotunheim. That right now, that before this was the only thing in my house that could actually power balanced output. But I don't put it here. Where's the Jotunheim, people ask? Why aren't you using the Jotunheim? Don't you like the Jotunheim? You spent $500 on Jotunheim. There's the Jotunheim. The Jotunheim's job is on my daily computer usage for gaming and when I'm browsing the internet and I'm listening to music. If I'm not here studying, working, that's where the Jotunheim is. It sits there being itself, so that I could take any headphones that I'm going to be reviewing in the next few days, and it sits on the Jotunheim. But now I'm here on my desk, and I wasn't going to buy another Jotunheim. I wasn't going to spend $1 trillion on a shit product. I mean, the next one would be just another Jotunheim without a DAC, and then I could have added it to this, and it would form. So at $250, yes, this isn't as powerful as the Jotunheim, but it's Class A, and it's clean. And we're going to hook up to some balanced stuff right now. Here's the back. Power input, audio in, audio out, which is variable. So this will actually act as a preamp, which is give or take. I thought I'd be able to pass from one to the other and add another, you know, bring it up. But then these are variable, so it's a little bit iffy. And then you do have to still unplug if you want to use these for, like, powered monitors. You didn't put your DAC. Control your headphones and unplug your headphones. Then it outputs constantly. But, you know, you don't want to be raising this up to control speakers if the headphones are still plugged in. Here are my feeds from the back of the X1S. Power's off. Here's my power plug, which is completely caught up and short. That goes there. Turn that on. There's no warm-up. There's no click. It just goes. It is just going. The only power indicator, look at it. See that little green dot? That's it. That's a little green dot as well. I fucking love you, Owen. Blue can go to hell. Even these cables are offensive to me. They're the only ones I had that were long enough just to do this. That's it. We're now running a Class A balanced headphone amp. $250 to get into the world of balance. You're either going to spend $500 for the whole deal, or you're going to spend this. Now, I know we talked about you need to go balance fully out from one to the other, and this would need XLR inputs and everything, but you got to hear it to believe it. And how are we going to hear it? Well, we're going to hear it with my breakout box that I made. And I had a video on my other channel, my alternate channel where Z Cooks was hosted, but now that's moved. And all this does is takes the four conductors that are coming out of here and turns them into 2 quarter-inch females. So ground on one, hot on one, ground on one, hot on one. And what that allows me to do is take headphones that can be hooked up balanced, i.e. these very, 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 very lovely Ether C Flows. And I can make my own balanced cables by buying a 10-foot patch cord. And these are Polynic, these are like $13 a piece. You got a 10-foot Polynic quarter-inch patch cord. Gold tips, and you cut it in half, and you solder on just your ends. So these come like this, and those you add, and I've got them for the Sennheisers. I made a set for the Sennheisers, I made a set for the Monoprice Monoliths, and I made a set for the 2000Xs. And now I haven't made a set for these, because I bought them. But now let's plug it in, and I just label these with a little dot. That's blue, that's left, that's red, that's right. And you don't want to use both outputs at the same time because it will affect it. I had two headphones plugged in, and then I unplugged one, and the sound changed. So that's bad news. You do not want to do that. I'm also going to test with you guys. What do I have? What can I trust? What needs power? No, it doesn't really need power, but old Class A. Class A on the 2000Xs. And we could take this cable. Yes. So now we got some hard to drive unbalanced, and we'll drive the 2000Xs unbalanced, running them through the Relic cable. One. And actually, we'll do this first. So let's unplug that. First into the X1S. Whispers, and the beat goes on from the Vice City soundtrack. Okay, now I'm going to set the volume about the same as that because they are similar. It's not a powerhouse, but it's Class A, which means it sounds better. All right, there's no other way I could put it. I'm not going to start getting into very audiophile-y terms. But and it's not a volume change either. I've obsessively gone back and forth and had the volumes match. And there's just a width and clarity increase with this over that. That's a very good output. I do all my testing with this. This just feels legitimately, like not like maybe, anybody could hear the difference between that and this. It's just a better amplifier. That thing's $300 for a very good DAC with a lot of features and a headphone amp. This is $200 for a headphone amp. And it's a completely different build. Class A is completely different than what's in that. Can I get something that was made maybe in this decade? Oh God. Nice, hope you heard that. Oof. Basement Jack's Buffalo. Oh. It's just lacking a little bit from what this is doing. There's a sold. Sold. It doesn't sound bad right now. If this doesn't exist, then this sounds great. But this does exist, so I can go. Just the sounds are. Fuck yes. You don't want to buy the. You could buy just this, feed it with any DAC you want, Sanskrit, you got a goddamn shit Mahdi, ODAC. This is my now go to headphone amp. It's only a watt out of this, which these are super efficient, so that doesn't matter. If we got something less efficient, oh, you know what I gotta get. Oh, fuck. I'm tired of getting them. All right, fine. I guess if you're spending if I'm asking you to spend $250 on a headphone amp, it better be able to push Mark IIIs. Give me one of these. Turn that down. Let's see if this can kill me. Class A is a different structure than most headphone amps, so. I paused it. Okay, that'd be good. Way up there. Fuck. Okay. So here's the thing. This dial goes completely around to 6 o'clock. And I just took it to like 4 o'clock and nearly died. So. Ow, you know. Okay, they have the powers. Wow. It powers Mark III's handily. So, no worries about that. Now, let's get on to the main event, which is plugging in my breakout box and putting on. Oh, yeah. God, they feel so good. So, I'm 12 o'clock. This would be loud for anyone. Through the balanced output, through the balanced breakout box, through my purple quarter inch cable. Next. Nerds. Bow to me, nerds. Oh yeah. It's such a good amp. Oh my god. Actually, I'm gonna switch it over, and now I could test like this. It's all right, not as good. It's not as. It's still good. This is great. It's not balanced, and now. I gotta take this nearly to maximum to match this. It's clean, but it's not the same. Oh, that's full tilt. Oof. These are not easy cans to drive. So I'm going through this, which is only a watt. And I can give them damn close to a watt. But now if I unplug this, and unplug this, because I'm not sure if that switches anything, but. Oh yeah. Oh no, what? Okay. Judge me for my music taste all the hell you want. That sounded amazing. Oh, the fucking sound of these. These and these with that DAC and this, oh, Led Zeppelin and. If you right now said, okay, you need another headphone amp, Zeos, you gotta put a headphone amp on that. It's gonna be one of these. It's gonna be one of these. Just an amp? I need just an amp. What's my budget? $300. It's gonna be one of these. What if it's $400? Oh, I forgot to mention something. There are gain switches in the bottom. Actual switches. Right now, it's in the middle. There's low, there's medium, and there's destroy every headphone you own. I have it in the middle. Because I had it on high gain, and it's unusable. It's literally from here to there. I felt unsafe having it on a full tilt because I put the knob up and I'm like, wow, that's loud here. And the knob will continue all the way to 6 o'clock. And I couldn't trust myself not to just brush against it and destroy everything. So I'm gonna leave it on medium. It comes on medium, you could set it to low, you could set it to high, try it, then put it back to medium, because you're not stupid. If I got HE6s here, which are like one of the hard, everyone says those are the hardest headphones to drive. Like, it's pretty much known as those are them. If I get a set of those, maybe I'll flip the switch. Maybe I'll flip the switch. Here, we want, I gotta do it because I'm doing goddamn reviews and these are gonna take forever and screwdriver, check. Plug-in headphones, check. Not Led Zeppelin. Give me something you could hear the actual volume change. Okay. Give me something that's consistent. Boom, that's loud. Actually, gorillas are awesome. Let's just put some gorillas on. Boom, rhinestone eyes. Alright. Half volume. Let's switch it off first. So lower the gain. Let's quiet it down quite a bit. That's full tilt. Okay, back to half. Medium gain. Alright, I'm gonna lower that, then put it to full gain, then try to put it back to half. That's half. At full tilt. Kill everyone on the earth. Oh, that's too loud. Yeah, you could damage something. So I'm gonna take it from full. It's just enough of a drop to make it manageable. And then low all the way is. Yeah, now I can max it out, and it's loud enough, maximum. But you don't ever want to run an amp at maximum, so I'm just gonna put it back to medium. You guys could all figure this out on your own. Just got a little screwdriver and you're done. That was the wrong direction. There we go. Yeah, medium is. Is it worth twice as much as a Magni 2? Yes. Magni doesn't have balanced. Again, this is a balanced issue. If you're just looking for a quarter inch, there are other options. But if you're looking to get into balanced stuff, and I'm obviously looking to get into balanced stuff, I've built cables for half my stuff and I'm probably gonna convert the rest. I'm gonna literally rip apart my X1s and I'm gonna put a four pole in there and I'm gonna, everything will be balanced. I'll be a balanced retard and I'm just gonna have a custom thing with a plug and it's gonna be done. And then it's worth it. It's definitely worth it. So that wasn't even on high gain and I was pushing T50s like nothing. Fuck these T50s. Oh man. Smoking, drinking, oh yeah. Fucking, oh yeah, okay. Now, we're back to the same problem about the switch for the power. It's again in the back. And just like the Jotunheim, this gets hot and will stay hot all the time. So I gotta shut it off. Which in my situation, this is going up here and then the Stax amp is going on top of that, so it's a bit of a fiddle. So unless I put a remote power switch on the goddamn thing, it's sort of annoying. And I'm sure that they would say, oh, just leave it on all the time, leave it on all the time, because what the hell is different? Just leave on the Jotunheim all the time, it's nice and hot. Leave all these hot things on in your room while you're out in the shopping. No. So, a little bit pissy about that. I could leave the X1S on all day. I do all the time. Because it's a DAC and a low power headphone amplifier. It doesn't get warm. It just sits there. This, I want to shut off. And it's a matter of reaching back and sliding. And God, it's pretty. If this was just a box, a square, it wouldn't be as pretty. That little curve. That subtle curve is just fucking perfect. Alright, things I love, things I've added to the setup. Probably a 25 minute video on something that has literally one knob and a switch. But it deserves it. It deserves all the screen time. It's gonna be played out a lot from now on when I'm testing headphones. In fact, I was just testing other headphones and I'm like, plug in there, they sound pretty good. Plug in there, oh, let's just test them with this. All right, the Aeris comes on every once in a while. I can almost sell it because because of this. Almost. It's still got a lot more power. It's got 5 watts coming out of it. So that's significant. Patreon link in the upper corner. Wallpaper download in the description. Remember, there's a description, guys. You know how many people don't just check the video's description ever for anything? I'll put like a link and then another, and then there'll be a space, and then if you hit show more, there's like usually an entire list of things you can click on. Just saying. You know, just giving you the heads up on that. And if this is on MassDrop, I'll find the link to it and link that again, because it is cheaper on MassDrop. And since there's only like 3 of them on Amazon as of the recording, I have no idea how many will be there, or if any will be there when I actually publish this. So yeah, there's, if you search my other channel, you'll find the build video for this breakout box, which I've added 26 cents worth of pennies to the back of it, because the front would flop down from the weight, and now the front still sort of does, but it's much better. Oh, and I love you. I just wish your other stuff wasn't so damn expensive. I'd try that too.